morning, everyone. Some time ago, as I came back home after office, my grandmother asked me to take a printout of an old family photo she loved. A fairly easy job. I promised to bring it the next day. But it was low on my priority list. I kept forgetting and eventually she stopped reminding me. A month later, I suddenly remembered about the left task. Racked with guilt, I took the printout to her. She was ecstatic. On asking why she wanted that particular photo, she simply said that it takes me back to the time when I lived in a world of possibilities. And that gave me a small window into her life, always dependent and so alone. A recent survey conducted by the Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare revealed that 30% of the 103 million people above the age of 60 in India are suffering from one form or the other form of depression. Welcome to the latest episode of Wake Up to Health Talks. Today, we talk about the mental health challenges that the senior citizens face. We have with us Dr. Ravi Soni, an expert on geriatric psychiatry, to talk more about this. Welcome, Dr. Soni.
Thank you.
So, sir, as I was mentioning, and there is this another statistic that I came across, that due to the population aging, the number of seniors with mental disorders is expected to double by 2030. What are some of these factors that are leading to these healthcare challenges that the senior citizens face?
So, as we see, when India became free, so we got freedom, so our life expectancy was around 50 years.
Mm-hmm.
And now we are living a little bit longer, much longer than the previous years. So we are living more than 70 years. Average life expectancy at birth is 70 years.
Mm-hmm.
So now we are getting older. Our population is growing. And as a person grows older, those health issues related to age plus mental health issues the person is facing in westernization.
Mm-hmm.
So we are facing so much stress nowadays, particularly elderly. And there are certain reasons for that. Mm-hmm. Because majority of elderly are now living alone. We usually call it as an empty nest syndrome. So, puri zindagi, pura ghar, humne sambhala hai, bachche bade kiye. But now they are leaving home for better opportunities, studies in India, in other cities, or in Western countries. So now, home is empty. So they feel lonely. They usually have questions ke hamara khayal kaun rakhega, hame kuch hoga to kya hoga, agar hum hospital mein admit honge to bhi hamara khayal kaun rakhega. Ha, they used to talk to their children through phone, video calls and all that. But somebody is with them in house, that makes better feeling for them. Emotionally, they are very much better if somebody is in the house.
Mm-hmm.
Another part is retirement.
Mm-hmm.
Some people take retirement as a positive sign. So they want to spend their time in their hobbies, exploring and all that. But for majority of the elderly, retirement is a loss. Job loss, monetary loss, the role in the family as a head is also lost. So they consider it as a loss. So that is the problem. So it is the major reason for depression. And after that comes the so many health conditions that happen with a older age, like diabetes, hypertension, thyroid issues, arthritis issues, and some of the terminal life illnesses. Some may have problem with liver, kidney, cancer, and all that. So all these part health makes a major role in their mental health. Overall, physical health has a major impact over their mental health. And if they have not planned their retirement financially, so they have a financial dependence over their children. And that also causes so many mental health issues. And apart from that, marriage of the children, new member is coming in the home, adjustment issues. So many problems are going on. And overall, if any kind of mental health issue develops, it has three major parts. Genetic causes, psychological causes, and social causes. So how the person's genetic is. If any family history of any kind of mental health issues, so they are more prone for developing that. And psychology, how the person is seeing everything around him through his mind, how he or she takes what is happening. So we say that some, in layman terms, we say that कुछ लोग ज्यादा चिंता करने वाले होते हैं, कुछ लोग साफ सफाई रखने वाले होते हैं, कुछ लोग जो होते हैं वो इंट्रोवर्ट होते हैं, कुछ एक्सट्रोवर्ट होते हैं. तो इस तरह का जितना भी पर्सनालिटी जो होती है वो अलग अलग पर्सनालिटी के लोग जो होते हैं उनको अलग अलग बीमारियां, मेंटल हेल्थ इश्यूज होने के चांसेस डिफरेंट होते हैं. और सोशल फैक्टर्स, व्हाट इज हैपनिंग अराउंड देम, लाइक रिटायरमेंट, डेथ ऑफ अ फ्रेंड, फैमिली मेंबर, इवन स्पाउस डेथ, फिर फाइनेंशियल लॉसेस or any property issue, conflict in the house, so many factors that are going on around them have impact on their mental health.
That's true. And actually it's a topic that is very close to my heart since I live with my grandparents, and I do feel that they're very lonely, and you know, all of these factors actually contribute to them feeling alone and feeling unhappy. And as you very well said, physical ailments is a big topic where, you know, physical ailments actually can contribute to their mental health. I wanted to understand, does that happen vice versa also? Are there any symptoms that we can look for? How can I identify whether my grandparents are suffering from any mental health challenges physically? Are there any physical symptoms associated with it?
If a person is having any kind of mental health issue, so the primary sign is that insomnia. Sleep disturbances. If they are developing sleep disturbances or not, they have started sleeping in the daytime, but now at night time they are not sleeping. Apart from that, easy fatigability. No, there are no physical illnesses that are causing weakness or anything, but they are feeling that I'm feeling lack of interest in doing any activity. Easy fatigability. Lethargy, they feel lethargy, and all these kind of signs and symptoms. Plus, some of the elderly usually tell that in the morning we are good, but as the day passes, in the evening we feel anxiety, we feel restlessness. Some of the elderly say that when we wake up in the morning, we are not feeling fresh, we feel fresh towards the evening part. So, these all are the signs that some of the mental health issues are going on. And they also start spending less time in their daily activities. Like previously, they were watching TV, reading newspaper, even playing games. But now they have lost interest, and now they are not engaging any kind of activity. They have lost contact with their social circle. Like every elderly used to go to park and they sit there and talk with their friends. Of similar age, like 60, 65, 70. But now they do not like that. They do not go there. They are not talking over phone to all of those friends. So when they are losing interest, so physically you can see that they are remaining in a home, in a secluded place only.
And are there any treatment options available for this? So what to help them?
So there are so many mental illnesses that can happen. So what are the mental health issues the elderly are facing? Depending on that, there are so many treatment options available. If the mental health issue is like depression or anxiety, we can primarily go for medication also and supportive therapy also, counseling also. In supportive therapy, usually role of the family member is very much important. Just sitting with them and listening to their previous stories of their life, their experiences, that is very beneficial for them to live that alone repeatedly, and plus they can share their experience. And usually elderly like that. Whenever we sit with them and they are telling their story, there is a smile on their face. So it is a reminiscence therapy. They are reminiscing. So this is a therapy that everybody can do. Even family member can sit and have a lunch or dinner with them, talk about their past and share some stories, plus seeing the previous albums of major events, like marriage of their marriage, their children's marriage, birth of a child and all that. That is a very good memories those are. So that can be done. And making a daily plan plan of activities. Like in the morning after they wake up, they have to go for exercise or pranayam, yoga, then newspaper reading, news watching in television. So all kind of plans. Plus that during evening hours they play games, carom or card games. Or so this kind of daily activity should be made for them so that they can be engaged in all throughout the day, and they feel better this way. Apart from, there are so many therapies, non-pharmacology, without medication, that can be done. But sometimes when these mental health issues are severe,
mm-hmm.
and they have sleep problems, plus they have reached to a level where they feel that life is not worth living, at that time, we must start medicines. And there are other treatment options are also available. But medications and counseling are the basis for the treatment for the mental health issues in the elderly.
True. And you said very some great points that, you know, maintaining a maintaining a healthy balance and, you know, going outside, meeting friends, that's very important. But COVID-19 has upended everyone's life. And I think it's the hardest for the grandparents and the senior citizens because the virus affects them more. It's more fatal to them. And so there are more restrictions on them. They cannot go out. They cannot talk to anyone. So is that contributing to their mental health challenges also? And what can we do to support it?
We can say that the COVID-19 has affected, if any age group, so at least elderly. It has affected children also, but elderly are affected most. Particularly those elderly who were living alone and those mm-hmm. who are dependent on somebody. If their family members, their children are not living with them, so mm-hmm. they are dependent on paid caregivers, nurses, maids, for their daily activities and their household activities. But
mm-hmm.
due to pandemic, restrictions have made hell for their life. And what we can do is, we can ask them to connect with their family members or mm-hmm. friends through mobile or social media or video calls. If they are not used to, we can just teach them. Apart from that, we can also ask them to stay away from certain news mm-hmm. of corona-related deaths, corona cases and all that. So we
extremely
can ask them to stay away from that. Apart from, we can focus on the daily activity. I just say that daily activity is very much important. So engaging mm-hmm. them throughout the day will make their mind very cool and they feel better. Plus, if we have time, plus we can also make a group of people or youngster or somebody that can visit certain, there are so many old age homes also. So particular place and just talk to them because they feel youngster as their grandchildren.
Mm-hmm.
So they will start talking, they will start sharing their feelings, they will talk about their life experiences. So it is really important. And we just ask them or to help them get their daily supply of medication.
Mm-hmm.
Because they are on so many medicines. Their daily supply of medication, groceries, all those needs are met properly and they mm-hmm. are taking their medicine. We should ask them about their sleep also. If they are not sleeping well, they mm-hmm. will be having mental health issues.
Mm-hmm.
So all these points we must take into consideration while dealing with elderly. And if we have an elderly in our home, so we can work on their activities. We can ask them to talk with their friends through phone, video calls, and make them stay away from the corona-related news or those worries or certain feelings they have said. We must start acting on them.
Very well said, sir. I think, grandparents, it actually, like to me also, engaging them for even short conversations can actually be very helpful. Thank you, Dr. Soni, for joining us today. It has been an insightful session. And the takeaway that I have, for all our viewers here, is try and spend more time with their grandparents. Try and spend more time with their, make their lives a little easier so that they can be more happy and they can be more satisfied. Thank you, Dr. Soni, for joining us. And thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
A wake up to high spots.